maestrina. And so, so I'm very excited to be in good hands with my current students and former students. I hope you enjoy the concert and come back next year, bring a friend.
It's a pleasure to be back at USM and on this stage after so many years. The piece I will play tonight is by Valerie Coleman, titled Fan Mi Himen, which translates to the human family. And it's based on, or at least is inspired by, a poem by American poet Maya Angelou, also named Human Family. And I won't talk too much about the piece, I'll let the piece speak for itself. But it's a short poem, and I rarely do that. But given the current events, and especially the special place that USM is, you can just look around, I think it's very pertinent for us to hear this poem before I play the piece. So here is Maya Angelou's Human Family. I note the obvious differences in the human family. Some of us are serious, some thrive on comedy. Some declare their lives are lived as true profundity, and others claim they really live the real reality. The variety of our skin tones can confuse, bemuse, and delight. Brown and pink and beige and purple, tan and blue and white. I've sailed upon the seven seas and stopped in every land. I've seen the wonders of the world, not yet one common man. I know 10,000 women called Jane and Mary Jane, but I've not seen any two who really are the same. Mirror twins are different, although their features jibe, and lovers think quite different thoughts when lie side by side. We love and lose in China, we weep in England's moors, and laugh and mow in Guinea, and thrive on Spanish shores. We seek success in Finland, are born and dine in May. In minor ways we differ, in major we are the same. I know the obvious differences between each sort and type, but we are more alike, my friends, than we are unalike. We are more alike than we are unlike. We are more alike, my friends, than we are unlike.
USM, the first Southern Flute Festival was actually the summer going into my master's. So it's so great to go full circle of being a participant and now being a guest artist here at this festival. So I'd like to thank Dr. Mazzotti for having me here today. So the first piece that I performed is Toccata in Fugue by Bach. Now that piece was originally written for organ. So to play that many parts, and it's a lot of notes as you can tell, with my music. So it's a feat to be said. So I'm gonna be chugging this water as I talk about my next few pieces. So the next two pieces I'm gonna perform for you, one is by one of my good friends, Nicole Chamberlain. She's a flutist composer. And she lived in Atlanta, Georgia, so also a Southerner. And she has made a name for herself in the flute world. And a lot of us perform her works just regularly. She has a lot of not only flute work, but flute, choir, and other chamber groups as well. And so she's one of my favorite composers, living composers. And it's so nice to perform a work when you know the composer, because you can kind of get in your head from just talking and laughing with them. So that piece that I'm going to perform next is called Asphyxia. And it's only fitting because asphyxia is basically, you know, a medical term that means a person is lacking oxygen or they're running out of breath. And so many of us, when we first begin to play the flute, do you remember that we got very lightheaded and dizzy as we were playing the flute? And then your band director was like, put your head between your legs so you can get some oxygen to yourself. Well, Nicole Chamberlain is doing a play on that. So basically, she composed a piece that has a lot of extended techniques that is meant to make the flute player out of breath. And so, as musicians, we always tell ourselves that we are not musicians, not only musicians, but we are, you know, athletes, we are actors on stage. Well, she took that to heart for this piece, this Fitzy. And then the next piece I'm going to perform after that is another piece by Judith Stanton. Now, it's called Penelope's Song. And if you are not, many of us have read the Odyssey in high school, right? This is, you know, if you're in AP English or something, most of the time we have to read, you know, read this book. Well, in the Odyssey, the story goes that, you know, Homer is like away from, he has to go on this long journey, okay? And he leaves his wife, Penelope. Well, because he leaves his wife for so long, he has the, people in the kingdom was like, oh my God, Queen, you need to get married soon. And so she was not about that life at all. She loved her husband, even though he was away for many years, and many of the people thought that he wasn't going to come back, but she knew he would come back. So the story goes that many suitors would come and meet her, and she would, like, you know, entertain them. But she said that she would not marry them until she got done with weaving her loom, because she had this really big little rug loom that she was knitting for her her husband, father. Well, at night, she would unweave that loom. And so she never really finished the project. And then many years later, when her husband came back, she wasn't here after that. I am good. Thank you so much. To not get remarried, but there. So you got to notice that, thank you, Dr. Mazzotti, the whole setup is a flute and electronic piece. Now, it's one of the simpler flute and electronic piece because it's just for amplified flute and like a fits media. So there is a backing track that I'm going to play against it. Yeah. Thank you. junior and senior recital, and so to come back to here, I bet it's bringing up memories for them as well. Called asphyxia. A lot of the spinet technique. hear some kind of sound effects with the electronics. But first, let me check everything. it was our last lesson of the semester, and I just ended up just bawling crying in his office. And now being a professor, I realize how awkward it is to have your student cry. But anyway, I was crying, and I was like, why am I doing all of these competitions? Like, what do you see in me? And he said, I think that you have what it takes to become a performer. And prior to that, I was a music ed major. And so I like to say, it's because of you that I'm in this profession today. So thank you so much. So a little bit about the piece that we're going to perform. So this is newly commissioned. I'm a part of this organization called Fleet Name Music Consortium. And this is a great, amazing piece by Samuel Zeman. He is a pianist and theory composition professor in New York, and he has created a whiff for the flute. I mean, flute players love him. His Sonata No. 1 and Sonata No. 2 are the staples in our repertoire, and this duet for two flutes called Intuition is going to be another staple.
called Arcadie, and we have three movements. It's by a composer, a French composer called Marc Bertomeu. It's originally for flute quartet, but we try to play with more than four.
Thank you.
choir, and then she also made an orchestral part of this piece, and also for flute choir. She actually was the first African-American composer alive to be performed by the Philadelphia Orchestra. So she performed this, they performed this piece. Ole. I don't know how to translate that, just ole.